Hello, welcome to Genius Channel. Today we'll be discussing NDA exam 2019. NDA exam 2019. Mathematics ka student. So let's see the first question. If both P and Q belong to the set 1, 2, 3, 4, then how many equations of the form Px square plus Qx plus 1 is equal to 0 will have real roots? Both P and Q belong to the set 1, 2, 3, 4. Then how many equations of the form Px square plus Qx plus 1 is equal to 0 will have real roots? Please try that. Options are 12, 10, 7, 6. Please try. So this comes from the chapter. We can say it is a mix of chapter set. Okay, but mostly this from the chapter. Quadratic equation. See here we have a quadratic equation and they have given a set 1, 2, 3, 4. That means P and Q belongs to this set. Okay, so what you need, it will have real roots. Please try real roots. What is the condition? If a quadratic equation is having real root, it's discriminant. It's discriminant, isn't it? Its discriminant should be greater than or equal to 0. That is the condition. If a quadratic equation is having real root, its discriminant should be greater than or equal to 0. Okay. Now, what do you mean by discriminant? What do you mean by discriminant? So, if the equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, this is a general quadratic equation, then b square minus 4ac, that is discriminant. B is b square minus 4ac. So if the roots are real, this should be greater than or equal to 0. So try that. Here in the place of b, we have q. So q square minus 4p into 1, isn't it? 4ac, 4p is p, c is 1. So that is greater than or equal to 0. That should be greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so we have to check which all numbers from this set 1, 2, 3, 4 satisfy this condition. Satisfy this condition. How many are there? Okay, so if I take 1 and 2, that is P is equal to 1, Q is equal to 2. That is 1, 2. That is a part of the set. Then if I take P as 1, Q as 2. So Q square minus 4P. So Q square means 2 square. Minus 4 into P is 1. So that what I am getting? I am getting 4 minus 4, isn't it? So that is 0. So that is satisfying this condition, isn't it? Greater than or equal to 0, it is 0. So 1 comma 2 is a possible pair. So first one is that. Then check for 2 comma 3. First of all, we'll take check 1 comma 2. Then we'll check, just check 1 comma 3 also. 1 comma 3. So that is 3 square minus 4. 3 square minus 4. That is 9 minus 4, 5. That is also greater than 0. So that also satisfies. So 1, 2. Then just check 1 comma 4. That also will satisfy this condition. That is 4 square minus 4, that is 16 minus 4, 12. That also satisfies. So 3. Now, just check 2 comma 3. That also will satisfy. Then 2 comma 4. That also will satisfy. You have to take each like 1 comma 2, 1 comma 3, 1 comma 4. Then check here. Then you have to take 2 comma 1. 2, 3, 2, 4. Okay, like that you have to take each two, two. They can take the pairs and check which all numbers satisfy this. Okay, then 2, 3 will satisfy, 2, 4 will satisfy, then 3, 4 will satisfy. That is 4² - 4 = 3. That is also greater than 0. So how many pairs will satisfy this condition? How many pairs will satisfy? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total 6 pairs will satisfy this condition. So the answer is, or option is option D. Option D, 6. Option D, 6. So if you get a quadratic equation, a question based on quadratic equation, so mostly maximum you can expect maximum of 3 questions. Maximum 2 to 3 questions you can expect from quadratic equation. And if you get a question from quadratic equation, you can surely score that, because only a few things you have to by heart from that chapter. As far as NDA exam is considered, only very few things you can by heart from this chapter. I'll just show that. Ax² + bx + c, that is equal to 0. That is the general equation of a quadratic equation. General quadratic equation. So from that discriminant, we have already seen b² - 4ac. If that is greater than or equal to 0, it is having real roots. b² - 4ac equal to 0, it will have 2 equal roots. If b² - 4ac is less than 0, it is having imaginary roots. Imaginary roots. No real roots. No real roots. So this is the first thing you have to study from this chapter. Now, if zeros of this quadratic equation, that is denoted as alpha and beta, zeros are alpha and beta. α + β = -b/a. α/β = c/a. C by a. So if we know this much things, we'll be able to do most of the questions from this quadratic equation. So this is the relation between zeros and coefficients. Zeros and coefficients. Relation between zeros and coefficient, that is shown here. α + β = -b/a, α/β = c/a. Then ax² + bx + c is equal to 0. From that, we can write discriminant and how discriminant is related to roots or zeros. Roots means they are zeros itself. Okay. So that's about the first question. So the answer for this question was option D, 6. Okay. Now we'll go to the next question. What is the value of 1 - 2 + 3 - 4 + 5 - etc. + 101? Options are 51, 55, 110, 111. Okay, 111. So, this is a question coming from sequences and series, a chapter known as sequences and series. So, let's see how to do this question. So you have to find the sum of this sequence, isn't it? So I'm just dividing this sequence as 1 + 3 + 5 + etc. up to 101. I'm just collecting the odd numbers. Minus, I'm just collecting the even numbers, because even numbers are getting subtracted. So minus 2 + 4 + 6 + etc. up to, that will be up to 100, isn't it? Because up to 101, here it is there. Now, this is an arithmetic sequence, isn't it? Or arithmetic progression. This is an arithmetic progression of odd numbers. This is arithmetic progression of even numbers. Now, what is the sum of an arithmetic progression? What is the formula? Sn is equal to n by 2 into first term plus last term. N by 2 into first term plus last term. So, n by 2, n means how many terms are there? N means how many terms are there? So, see here, how many terms will be there up to 101? How many terms will be there up to 101? There will be 51 terms, isn't it? 51 terms in this sequence. So, n by 2 means 51 by 2. First term means 1 plus last term is 101. Minus, how many terms will be here? 2 to 100. So there will be 50 terms, isn't it? So 50 by 2 into first term, that is 2, plus last term, it is 100. So it is 51 by 2 into 1 plus 101, that is 102. Minus here 50 by 2, 2 plus 100, 102. So 51, this will be cancelled here. 51. So 51 into 51 minus 50 into 51. So the answer is 51, isn't it? 51. No need to square, just take 51 outside. So it will be 51 minus 50. So that is 51. So the answer is 51. 51 into 51 minus 50 into 51. So surely it will be 51, isn't it? So, option A, 51. Next question. If A, B, C are subsets of a given set, which of the following relations is not correct? You have to identify the not correct relation. If A, B, and C are subsets of a set. So if we have a universal set, then inside that we have A, B, C, and they have not said any relation from intersecting. If A, B, or C anything intersecting, they have not given any information regarding that. So maybe they may be intersecting or not. Anyhow, we have to check the options. But as of now, they have not given any information whether A, B, or C anything is intersecting. Okay, so let's see each option. First option. A union A intersection B is A union B. A union A intersection A. A union A intersection B, isn't it? So first option, A union A intersection B. See, A union A is A. But they have not given any information on A intersection B, isn't it? So this can be stated as A union A intersection A union B. So A union A is obviously A intersection A union B. So we don't know what is A union B, whether it is intersecting or anything, nothing is given, isn't it? So this statement, we cannot say that this is correct. Okay, we cannot say that this is correct. Okay, so that is an incorrect statement. Okay, so let's see the remaining statements too. A intersection A union B. So what is that? A, this can be written as A intersection A union A intersection, isn't it? A intersection A, because here it is intersection. Okay, so this can be written as A intersection A union A intersection B Now, A intersection A, that will be obviously A union A intersection B. They have not told that A and B are intersecting, whether they are disjoint or intersecting set. So, we can take that as phi. So, A union phi is obviously A, isn't it? A union phi is obviously A. So, this is correct statement. Now, A intersection B union C. A intersection B union C. So, that is A intersection C. A union C. A union C. Because this is just like multiplication. So, A union C intersection A B union C. A union C intersection B union C. Just like how we open the brackets. So that is correct. Now see this one. Here it is A union B intersection C. So that is A intersection C union B intersection C. A intersection C union B intersection C. Okay, so A intersection C union B intersection C. So that is also correct. Okay, so the B, C, D are correct. So which is the incorrect option? The first one. Okay. So that is because A union A intersection B. A intersection B, if they are disjoint set, it can be phi, isn't it? So A union phi is A. It is not A union B. Okay. So this is the incorrect statement. So that is the answer for this question. Okay. So you have to check each options. If the first option itself you are confident that it is incorrect, you need not check, go for the remaining options. But I just wanted to explain how to open this. That's why. Okay. Let's see the next question. If the sum of first n terms of a series is n plus 12, what is the third term? If the sum of first n terms of a series is n plus 12, then what is the third term? Okay, please try. So this is also a question from sequence and series. So from this chapter also, you can expect minimum two questions, maximum up to four questions you can expect from this chapter. Minimum two questions you can expect, maximum they can ask four questions. Okay, let's see. So they have given sum to n terms is n plus 12, isn't it? So let's substitute for n. Suppose S1. S1 means sum of first term. That is the first term itself, isn't it? That is the first term itself. Sum of first term means that is only first term itself, isn't it? So that is n plus 12. That is 1 plus 12. So that is 13. Next S2. That means sum of first two terms. That is A1 plus A2, isn't it? A1 plus A2. So that is 2 plus 12, isn't it? 2 plus 12, that is 14. N is 2 now here. So that is 2 plus 12, 14. So we have a1 as 13. Okay, a1 as 13. So what is a2? A2 will be 1, isn't it? A2 is equal to 1 because a1 is 13 means a2 is 14 minus 13. So a2 is 1, isn't it? So a1 you got as 13. A2 you got as 1. Okay. Now what will be a3? S3 that will be, S3 will be what? This S3 will be 3 plus 12, that is 15. Isn't it? So that is what? That is a1 plus a2 plus a3. So a1 plus a2, we have 14. So 14 plus a3. So what is a3? A3 you will get as 1. So 15 is equal to 14 plus a3. So a3 will get as 1. Okay, so when you get a question based on n terms, you have to first just put these 1, 2, 3 values, then just compare. If S1 will be surely A1, first term. So first term you will get. Then the second, S2 will be first term plus second term. So from that you can get the second term. Then similarly, S3 will be first term plus second plus term plus third term. So first two terms sum is 14. So 14 plus A3 will be the sum to third term, isn't it? So A3 is equal to 1. A3 is equal to 1. So the answer is option E. Next question. What is the value of k for which the sum of the squares of the zeros of this equation is minimum? What is the value of k for which sum of the squares of roots? Sum of the squares of roots. So this is a question from quadratic equation. Sum of the squares of roots means if alpha and beta are roots. If alpha and beta are roots, you have to find sum of the squares. Squares means alpha square, beta square. Sum of the squares means alpha square plus beta square. That should be minimum. This should be minimum. Okay, so please try. Under what value of k you will have the sum of the squares minimum? Please try. Okay, so we need alpha square plus beta square minimum, isn't it? So can I write as alpha square plus beta square as alpha plus beta the whole square minus 2 alpha beta? Alpha plus beta the whole square minus 2 alpha beta. You can write that, no? Because when I open alpha square plus beta square plus 2ab minus 2 alpha beta, you get alpha square plus beta square. Okay. Now, for a quadratic equation, what is the relation between their zeros? I'm writing here, just see. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Alpha beta is equal to c by a. So, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. So, what is that? Minus b by a. So, b in here it is minus 2k minus 2. So, minus 2k minus 2 divided by a. A is 2, isn't it? So when you cancel this, you get it as minus b by a now. So minus and this minus will go. So that you will be getting as k minus 2. Then alpha beta equal to c by a. What is c? C is minus k plus 1 by a is 2. So that is, we cannot simplify that. So it is minus k plus 1 by 2. Now I'm just substituting that here. Alpha plus beta is k minus 2. So k minus 2 the whole square plus minus 2 into alpha beta is minus k plus 1 by 2. So this minus and this minus will go 2 and 2 will go. Okay, so here I have k minus 2 the whole square plus k plus 1. K minus 2 the whole square plus k plus 1. So k minus 2 the whole square, when I open, that will become, that will become k square minus 4k, isn't it? K square minus 4k plus 4. K square minus 4k plus 4. Then here I have k plus 1. Isn't it? So I'm writing the remaining part here. So I got alpha square plus beta square as k square minus 4k plus 4 plus k plus 1. So that is k square minus 3k plus 5. Isn't it? K square minus 3k plus 5. Okay. What I need this value as minimum. This as minimum. This as minimum. So if this is minimum, what is k? Okay, so let's try how can we find k here. So I'm just using completing the square method here. So I'm just rearranging this k square minus 3k. Okay, if I go for completing the square method, I have to add something and subtract something. So what I will add and subtract, I will add the half of 3. So that is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 square I will add. So 3 by 2 square means 9 by 4. Then I will subtract 9 by 4 itself plus 5. So I am subtracting 9 by 4 and 9 by 4. Adding and subtracting 9 by 4. Remaining things I am keeping as such. K square minus 3k plus 5. So how I get this 9 by 4? Just divide 3 by 2 then square that. That method is called as completing the square method. Now I can write k square minus 3k plus 9 by 4 as k minus 3 by 2 the whole square and 9 by 4 minus 9 by 4 plus 5, I can write it as 11 by 4. 11 by 4, isn't it? Because 5 into 4, 20 minus 9, 11 by 4. Okay, so this value should be minimum. This value should be minimum. So this value should be minimum means this part should go as 0. Then only this will have minimum. Otherwise, any value here coming, when I square that, that will be positive and I will add that to 11 by 4. So my value will increase. So for this should be minimum means this part, no? That means this k minus 3 by 2 the whole square. This part should be 0. Okay. So I am just equating k minus 3 by 2 to 0. So k I will get as 3 by 2. K I will get as 3 by 2. So the minimum value is possible when k is equal to 3 by 2. Okay. So the answer is option C. Option C. Next question. So I'm going for a GP, AP GP question. I'll do the next after doing the seventh question. After doing the seventh question, we'll be going to the sixth question. So listen. If modulus of x square minus 3x plus 2 greater than x square minus 3x plus 2. Modulus of x square minus 3x plus 2 greater than x square minus 3x plus 2. Which of the following is correct? Which of the following is correct? Okay. So I'm just removing this modulus. So I can write it as minus of x square minus 3x plus 2. Okay. Greater than x square minus 3x plus 2. Okay, I'm removing this modulus. So my condition becomes minus of x square minus 3x plus 2 greater than x square minus 3x plus 2. Okay, so I'm just taking everything to one side. So this is minus x square plus 3x minus 2 minus x square plus 3x minus 2 greater than 0. I'm taking everything to the other side. So this will become minus 2x square plus 6x minus 4 greater than 0. So if I take minus 2 outside, I'll get it as x square minus 3x plus 2 greater than 0. Isn't it? Minus 2 x square minus 3x plus 2 greater than 0. Now it's just solving. So 0 by minus 2, that will become 0. Now I have x square minus 3x plus 2 greater than 0. Now just do a middle term splitting here. So this can be splitted as x minus x square minus 2x minus x plus 2 greater than 0. So it is x square. So if I take x common, I'll get x into x minus 2 minus 1 into x minus 2 greater than 0. That is x minus 1, x minus 2 greater than 0. X minus 1, x minus 2 greater than 0. So x minus 2, x minus 1 greater than 0. So what is the interval possible? What is the interval possible? For this should be greater than 0 means both should be negative or both should be positive. Then only if we multiply, you will get greater than 0. Isn't it? So see, the first condition, if x less than 1, x less than 1, so this will be negative. Isn't it? X less than 1 means this will be negative. So x is equal to 1 means this will go 0. Okay, so the first condition cannot be. Second condition also, if we are putting x as 1 or 2, this will go to 0. It will not become, but the condition is it should be greater than 0. So the possible value is 1 less than x less than 2. Because any value in between 1 and 2 is okay. That will be obviously greater than 0. If I put 1.1, for example, if I put 1.1 here, okay, that will be satisfying the condition, isn't it? So the correct answer is 1 less than x less than 2.